Morning dear students, here is your video for 16th April 2020. Today we are going to discuss in details about the nucleus. Here is a three-dimensional structure of the nucleus depicting, this is the outer membrane which is showing the nuclear pores. Inside the fluid is nucleoplasm, a dense structure nucleolus. The nuclear membrane is also double layered, outer membrane and inner membrane, and inside there are chromatin fibers. So let's see the important points. It is a dense protoplasmic body that contains hereditary information for controlling cell activity. All activities of the cell, all activities of any organism is controlled by the genetic material or the chromosomes. Some cells have more than one nucleus, like the muscle cells, and another cell, it's a unicellular organism, paramecium. Now they show extra activity because of which they have extra nucleus present. We discussed about cells which do not have nucleus, and there are also cells which have extra nucleus. We call them nuclei. Now the nuclear envelope. It is a double membrane. It has pores to allow transfer of material from inside to the cytoplasm. If you look here, if there are certain activities going on here to guide the cell. See, this is a nucleus. Outside the nucleus is the cytoplasm. So from here, the information goes through the nuclear pore into the cytoplasm. So these pores allow transfer of materials from inside to outside, that is into the cytoplasm. Nucleolus, as we have discussed, is a dense structure. It helps in synthesis of ribosomes. Ribosomes, after being synthesized here, move again into the cytoplasm through the nuclear pore. Then the most important feature of the nucleus is the chromatin material. They are thread-like structures. They can become rod-like during cell division, and we call them chromosomes. They are made up of deoxyribonucleic acids. Now, what is deoxy? This is a type of biomolecule that the DNA is, the chromosomes are made up of. And these chromosomes wrap around proteins to get arranged in a very orderly manner. And these DNA, they carry the information for inheritance characters that we inherit, and it is coded by the DNA. Like you might have heard people saying, you look like your father, your eyes are like your father, your nose is like your mother. So these are characters which we have inherited from our parents. These were present on the DNA the parent, our parents are having. We got the DNA from our parents, and that's the reason we are also having those same features. Now see, this is the structure of the chromosome. When they get condensed, the chromatin material, when they get condensed, they look like this. Next is, there are 23 pair of chromosome in humans. You see, they have been numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to 22. And there is the sex chromosome. You all have heard about the sex chromosome. There are total 22 autosomes and a sex chromosome, which is as X and Y. Inside the cell, this is your cell. Inside the cell, the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, these chromosomes are arranged. So DNA looks somewhat like this. They get arranged around proteins. These proteins and the DNA together coil up to a dense coiling and form this chromosome. A chromosome looks under some high magnification microscopes. They are like dense mass, somewhat like this. They have been stained here blue. So this is how they look. You can't see much under a normal microscope, but then this is what they look like. Because the chromatin material has having the all the characters that are to be processed by the cell, we call the nucleus the control room of the cell. They carry genetic information to the progeny also. When the cell undergoes division, it is taking the information to the progeny. As I told you, some characters we get from our parents, both the parents. Why? Because the information has been brought into our body with the help of the chromosomes that are present in our parents. They also control metabolic activities. Now, metabolic activities are those, all the chemical activities which go on inside a cell are known as the metabolic activity. They regulate the chemical activities of the cell, instruct the various parts of the cell. So this nucleus, the information over here, it is controlling the whole cell. The whole cell is being controlled by the nucleus, and then the cells together, the information from the nucleus together, control the other cells as well as the whole organism. Like all of a sudden, if you feel you're scared, you have a feeling of scariness, that is because there are some cells which are secreting some chemicals in your body and they make you feel that you are scared. Suppose you are very happy, you start smiling. Why does that happen? The brain cells instruct some of your cells to produce the hormones, the chemicals, and as a result you smile. So these are all the work which is done by the cell. The cell's nucleus, it is very complicated. They do lot of whatever activities the body does, it is just controlled by the nucleus of the cell. Now, talking of another feature of the nucleus, the nucleoplasm. It is a colorless, dense sap found inside the nucleus in which chromatin and nucleolus are suspended. So the fluid that is present inside the nucleus is known as nucleoplasm. And I hope you remember, it was Purkinje who had coined the term protoplasm. Now, what is protoplasm? Protoplasm is all the fluid that is present inside the cell membrane. He named it as protoplasm. Now, protoplasm is inclusive of the nucleoplasm as well as the cytoplasm. So, nucleoplasm plus the cytoplasm is your protoplasm. So, this is it. Cytoplasm is the combination of cytoplasm is protoplasm minus the nucleoplasm. So, whatever is bound inside the cell membrane, if we remove the nucleoplasm, whatever is left is your cytoplasm. It is a fluid content or jelly-like substance found outside the nucleus but within the cell membrane. It is rich in water, minerals, vitamins, proteins, hormones, carbohydrates, medium in which all the cell organelles float. It is a medium in which all the cell organelles are floating. It's the fluid where all the cell organelles are suspended. It helps in exchange of material between cell organelles. So if it is a liquid medium, definitely it will allow movement of substances from one organelle to the other organelle. Also, whatever is coming out of the nuclear pore will be guided to a specific organelle or specific location in the cell through the cytoplasm. It also helps in exchange, they act as a site of chemical reaction. So all the metabolic activity, all the chemical reactions that are going on inside the cell, they occur in the cytoplasm. So cytoplasm is a very important part of the cell. No cell is without the cytoplasm.
It houses the DNA. It protects your genetic information and directs the synthesis of ribosomes and the expression of your genes. It's also the location of transcription and DNA replication. You can think of it as the brain of the cell. The nucleus has a very distinct structure. It's surrounded by a double membrane called the nuclear envelope, which contains special nuclear pores through which ribosomes and RNA exit. This nuclear envelope protects the DNA from nuclease enzymes in the cell, whose job it is to destroy nucleotides, and you don't want your DNA destroyed. The DNA never leaves the nucleus for the same reason. Within the nucleus, there's a dark region called the nucleolus. This area is densely packed with RNA and proteins and is the location of ribosome assembly, among other functions. Ribosomes have a big impact on cellular processes, and I'll create a separate video about ribosomes and link it here when it's ready. The nucleolus sits in the nucleoplasm, which encompasses the remaining contents of the nucleus. This is where the DNA is located. When the cell is getting ready to divide, the DNA forms chromosomes. These are structures you may be familiar with. Humans have 46 chromosomes in each cell. However, most of the time, the DNA is not in this chromosome structure, but is called chromatin, with the DNA being less compact and wrapped around special histone proteins. If you are a student interested in saving time in your studies, consider subscribing and hitting the bell to keep up.
It houses the DNA.
It protects your genetic information and directs the synthesis of ribosomes and the expression of your genes. It's also the location of transcription and DNA replication. You can think of it as the brain of the cell. The nucleus has a very distinct structure. It's surrounded by a double membrane called the nuclear envelope, which contains special nuclear pores through which ribosomes and RNA exit. This nuclear envelope protects the DNA from nucleus enzymes in the cell, whose job it is to destroy nucleotides, and you don't want your DNA destroyed. The DNA never leaves the nucleus for the same reason. Within the nucleus, there's a dark region called the nucleolus. This area is densely packed with RNA and proteins, and is the location of ribosome assembly, among other functions. Ribosomes have a big impact on cellular processes, and I'll create a separate video about ribosomes and link it here when it's ready. The nucleolus sits in the nucleoplasm, which encompasses the remaining contents of the nucleus. This is where the DNA is located. When the cell is getting ready to divide, the DNA forms chromosomes. These are structures you may be familiar with. Humans have 46 chromosomes in each cell. However, most of the time, the DNA is not in this chromosome structure, but is called chromatin, with the DNA being less compact and wrapped around special histone proteins. If you are a student interested in